As it has been expressed in the lives of our family circle and our friends who have come together to celebrate this day. But mostly we are grateful for your love as it is now being expressed in the lives of Maria, Gabriella, and John Byrne, who come together to be joined in holy marriage. Our prayer for them is that their love is a great love, one that will blossom into a home, and a home that will become a sanctuary of your presence, beginning with this day and continuing through all the days ahead. Surround them now with your love and us with your presence as we worship you in this service of holy marriage through Jesus Christ our Lord, in the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dearly beloved, we are gathered together today in the sight of God to celebrate the joining together of Byrne and Gabi in the covenant of holy marriage. The word covenant is a biblical term. We don't hear it too often in this modern day and age. It's the Bible's way of referring to two relationships: God's relationship with us and the relationship between a husband and wife. If we take a moment to consider God's covenant with us, we'll better be able to appreciate and celebrate the relationship that brings us here today. If we were to describe the terms of God's covenant with us, much like we describe the terms of our contract before we sign our name on the dotted line, those terms could be expressed quite simply. If we on our part are faithful in following God, many ways he leads each and every one of us in this life, God has promised on his part to be faithful in leading us to the promised land. Now, if there's one thing that we all have in common here, whether we're from Venezuela, the United States, whether we're female or male or young or old, rich or poor, it doesn't make any difference. We're all looking for what the Bible calls the promised land, which is the good life, the full life, the abundant life. Even John Farrell is looking for the promised land. Sometimes we think we can create that promised land on our own. We think, well, if I could just marry the woman of my dreams, if we could settle into a home and raise a family, or, you know, if we could win the scratch-off lottery in Ohio, a possible $2 million. We think that'll be the promised land. This is what happens when my wife sends me out to buy a wedding present. And, Byrne, this is for you. Congratulations. You know what? There are people who have all this and even more, whose lives are nevertheless kind of screwed up. And that's because the promised land is not something that we can buy or create for ourselves. It is a place that only God can lead us to. And only if we are faithful in following him, as he has promised to be faithful in leading us there. Now likewise, John Byrne and Maria Gabriella have come together to be joined in the covenant of holy marriage. They discovered that their lives cannot be complete or happy or fulfilled without the other one as a partner. So they're coming to be married. But just like we try to create the promised land on our own, sometimes we try to create a marriage on our own. We think, well, if I do my part to put the food on the table, or if I do my part to keep the household. Well, why, that'll be a marriage. And we think we're pretty together and enlightened in this modern day. But a lot of people have trouble staying together, and maybe we're not any more enlightened than any other generation. We need God's help to do what we are really powerless to do for ourselves, which is to create a marriage. I'm sorry I don't have the power to do it for you today, but God has the power to do it. Bringing two lives together as one life, their souls as one soul, is a miracle that only God can perform. But God has promised to make a miracle today. He's promised to make a marriage today. He's promised to make one that will last. He's promised to make one that will blossom and grow as long as you let God do what God does best, which is to create love in the lives of two people like you or one another. So will you be faithful to God by being faithful to the love He has given you for one another? Will you?
We will.
Okay.
Then on the basis of your pledge of love and faithfulness to God and to one another, I invite you to turn and take each other's hands, and eye to eye and soul to soul, to exchange your wedding vows. Byrne will begin with you. I, John Byrne.
I, John Byrne.
Take you, Maria Gabriella.
Take you, Maria Gabriella.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To love.
To love.
To honor.
To honor.
And to cherish.
And to cherish.
Until death.
Until death.
We do part.
We do part.
I, Maria Gabriella.
I, Maria Gabriella.
Take you, John Byrne.
Take you, John Byrne.
To be my lawful wedded husband.
To be my husband.
To love.
To love.
To honor.
To honor.
And to cherish.
And to cherish.
Until death.
Until death.
We do part.
We do part.
Nick, may I have the rings, please?
Don't cry.
I'm holding in my hand two rings made of gold. I'll tell you something about gold. It can get you into trouble in this life. No matter how much we have, we always want more. Some want it so badly they're inclined to cheat a little bit for it around income tax time. Some people have stolen it. Some people have killed for it. And it makes you wonder how something as worldly as gold found its way into a spiritual service of worship like this. But Jesus used to take valuable worldly things, and he would draw a spiritual message from them. He took a pearl once. He said, "The kingdom of heaven is like a pearl of great price." Likewise, these two give these rings to one another, not to suggest that you can buy love or keep it with money. But they give these rings to one another to symbolize how precious their love is for one another, how priceless it is. Something never to be cheapened by buying or selling. In the days ahead, as these rings reside upon your fingers, I hope they serve to remind you that even if you don't acquire as much gold as you'd like in this world, as long as you found true love with that special person of God's choosing, you already possess the better part of what this world has to offer to make your lives complete and good and full. And these rings are in the form of a circle to suggest the never-ending quality of love. God never brings two people like this together and creates a love in their hearts for one another just for it to end. That's why it hurts so much when love ends. Therefore, what God has brought together, let no one separate. Byrne, as you place this ring on Gabriella's. With this ring, I wed myself to you.
I wed myself to you.
Together with all that I am.
Together with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I receive this ring.
I receive this ring.
As a token of your love.
As a token of your love.
And pledge to wear it faithfully.
And pledge to wear it faithfully.
As your wife.
As your wife.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I wed myself to you.
I wed myself to you.
Together with all that I am.
Together with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I receive this ring.
I receive this ring.
As a token of your love.
As a token of your love.
And pledge to wear it faithfully.
And pledge to wear it faithfully.
As your husband.
As your husband.
She got one that's going to stay on there, brother. Maria Gabriella invites you to join together with them right now in a moment of silent prayer, allowing each of us in our own particular fashion to ask God's blessing upon their marriage. And as they do so, and as we join them, our hearts go out to our expanded family around the world. Rezando con nuestro nuevo familia in Venezuela y Chile. Mama Leda, hermana Alejandra y Ruben. Hermano Fernando in Chile. Abuelos Felicita y Nemesio, Hijita, Arista. Surrounded by that great cloud of witnesses, let us join our hearts in prayer. For as much as John Byrne and Maria Gabriella have consented to be joined together in holy marriage and have signified the same by the exchange of vows and the giving and receiving of rings, I hereby pronounce them husband and wife. Byrne, you may kiss your bride. To introduce to you for the first time as husband and wife, Byrne and Gabriella Farrell. And instead of having you come up to greet the happy couple, they are going to go out and greet you. And before they do, I ask you to excuse me, I am going to kiss a married woman.
I know.
Can't win them all.
It's mine. Oh.
Fight the whole world.
Did you see the sky? I'm getting my video clip done first. She's shaking it up. She knows how.
Missing two.
Easy.
You should have called this.